Hi, this is Kathy Clark from your garden variety. I'm just going to do you another demonstration of how to make another easy and relatively inexpensive fall / Thanksgiving centerpiece using live materials and some dried and actually some edible. This is what the finished product looks like here. It's a cornucopia, a very familiar Thanksgiving holiday symbol. Mine is fairly chock full of beautiful fall color. Just going to point out real quick what some of these things are. Might surprise you. I'll start from top to bottom. Obviously, there's some beautiful fall roses. I used as I did in my previous segment, I used a real pretty bunch of flowers from Whole Foods. You can pick and choose whatever you like if you've got a favorite nursery or a favorite store that you can shop for fresh cut flowers. You know, play, just mix colors. But they oftentimes this time of year will have, you know, gorgeous bunches of various things. There's two separate bunches that were in here. You can obviously see there's some pretty fall roses, as I said. We've got a lot of other fall greens in color here. I've also got some wheat berry, which is this little bunch here. It's on a stem. This actually is something you eat when it's cooked, but it's got beautiful fall color. This is wheat, a form of wheat here, very recognizable, and it's got some really spiky black fronds to it as well. This is Blueparium, this little Dr. Seuss looking flower here. So the purple is really rich and kind of complements the oranges and such. I've got decorative peppers. People ask if these are edible. I honestly do not know, but I generally tell people no because they're usually sold as as part of a floral arrangement or a potted plant. So I assume you probably could, but I wouldn't suggest it. And they come in all different shades. They start from a green, and they progress through a sort of blackish purple, then ultimately to a red. So you get all those different shades if you get a nice bunch. There's some very waxy greens here that I thought were pretty because they pick up the light. Those, again, were just part of a bunch of greens at Whole Foods. I've got a little bit of non-eucalyptus here. These fronds, I'm not certain of the name of these, but they're beautiful because I like the fact that they're very long and slender, and they kind of extend out from the front of the display, so they give it a little length, and the other flowers, the other items tend to give it some height. There's a little small little cabbage here. You'll see these all the time in the fall. They come in various shades. Usually they're sort of a purple with a very, very bright green, but those can vary and there's another right there. They can vary in terms of their style. The shape in the flower. And then I also want to point out what I've got in here. It's a little covered now since I filled this in, but this is actually kale. I put in a couple of different kinds of kale. Obviously a very healthy food. It's a superfood, so if you do use it, you can tell your guests they can eat part of the arrangement if they like. But basically, I love the fact that it's got the purple veins through the leaves. Kale comes in a bunch of different colors and varieties. I have some here. This is purple kale, which is a gorgeous color, almost a black purple. That I didn't get it. I was just sort of making this at home, so I didn't put any of this in. This is generally a shorter plant, so the stems are going to be a little shorter. So when you use these, you're going to kind of just tuck them in. And again, they're going to start to wilt by the end of your, they might stay for a day or so, but eventually you're going to have to pull them out and either eat them or throw them away. This is the other kale. This is red kale. It's got a little, looks more purpley, but that's when, it's got some purpley veins to it. And then this is another yummy vegetable. This is chard, Swiss chard. This is rainbow chard. Again, it's a really healthy food. It's delicious. You just steam it, and it's very healthy for you. There's a lot of fall greens like this, but this particular rainbow chard is beautiful if you happen to use it. I use it in cut arrangements, and when it's a plant, I use it in potted plants as well, but the color is just very intense. But this is another fairly lengthy, long-leafed green, so you can actually put that in sort of towards the bottom to kind of give it some length, but I just think the color is outstanding. And then finally, the other ingredients, as I said, were just some cut flowers. There's a few of them here that I used, and you can kind of just play. But the thing that I want to show you right now is the way that I got these in here, they're not all just jammed in there. You want to keep this arrangement alive as long as possible. As I said, I like to do live things, so you have to find a way to keep them watered, basically. So what I've done is there's a product called Oasis. It's a foam, but it's a special kind of one. There's two different ones you'll see in a craft store. One is dry, and it's meant for just to put in like dried flowers and hard stems, things like that. It does not sustain the plant material at all because it has no moisture to it. But this is called Oasis. This is a knockoff of it, basically. I got it at Michael's. It comes in brick form like this. Or it comes in a ball, and this is just half of the ball. I used half of this in here. It's in basically back inside the back end of the cornucopia here, and this the rounded part is facing out, so you have a surface to put the stems in. But what you do with this is it's real easy. You just take a bowl of water, maybe a bowl about this big, depending on what you've got to soak. And what it does is it basically absorbs water. They tell you in the directions to not submerge it. Don't push it down and try to get it wet fast. What you're going to want to do is just let it sit there for about 1 to 2 minutes. It's already starting to sink into the bowl. It basically absorbs the water very quickly. You just want to let it do it naturally. So you can kind of see where it's starting to pick up the water. You want to let it do that naturally so that it doesn't develop air bubbles in there, because what will happen if there's air bubbles and they get trapped in there and you're putting a stem in an air bubble, it's the piece of plant material is not going to survive. And it only takes about 2 minutes to totally saturate it with water. And once that's done, it won't even really drip much. It essentially holds all the water right inside. So this is a good volume of water in here. So I put this together last night, and the plants are still pretty fresh. So what I would suggest you do if you want to sustain it for a few days, which I would recommend because it's so pretty, is just take a water bottle and just fill it up. You're going to have to kind of guesstimate a little bit because this has a lot of, it's woven and there's some openings here. I can actually see where the oasis is in there. I would just take a water bottle or something with a straw and just very gently kind of, pour a little water into the, through one of the cracks in the cornucopia, just to keep it moist. But as I said, it should last for a while. You're also going to want to make sure you have it on a tray of some kind or a plate, because it will, some of the water will drip out and you don't want to have, ruin your tablecloth. But anyway, so that's the finished product there. I also wanted to, and so what I did is I took the all of the stems of the flowers. This is one where it's real important to, whenever you use this kind of foam, the oasis, it's real important to take your scissors, and you want to cut everything at an angle. It allows it a real sharp point to get into the foam and to stay in there securely, but it also gives more surface area for the water to get into the stem, and instead of cutting it across this way, you want to cut it in an angle. Depending on how full you want the arrangement to look, and if you like the leaves on the cut flowers, you can either strip them off or you can leave them on. What I would suggest doing, as I did here, is start with something that's long, like these leaves here are very long. Make like a base this way, and then I kind of filled in with some fluffy kale to kind of make like a nice little bed for the rest of the products I was going to put in. Okay, and you can also obviously tuck in some of the purple kale too, and the same thing goes for the chard. It can all sort of sit inside the edges here. Anything with stems this fragile, I would not try to jam them into the oasis, because it's not worth it. They're just going to break. But just bear in mind that over time, the leaves are going to wilt, so you might want to start pulling some of them out after about 24 hours, and preferably eat them. Some other pretty decorative pieces you can use alongside this. Again, it depends on how big your table is and how big you want the centerpiece to be and how much space you want it to take up. I do like to use organic materials for the entirety of the decoration. So I've found, the things you can find are gorgeous pomegranates. These are relatively inexpensive at this point. Get a nice shiny one. Make sure that it's not soft. Pomegranates, any form of apples. I mean, apples are a fall color and a fall fruit, and the color is complementary too. Artichokes, readily available. Just get a nice whole artichoke. And again, if you're not familiar with how to eat them afterwards, they're easy to Google. They're actually kind of fun to eat. But you can, display those in any which way you want around the outside of the arrangement. And lastly, if you want to, you can incorporate some nuts or other dried pieces. I used these in the last segment that I did too. Very easy to find. Marshall's carries them. You know, they're basically they're meant to fill a vase with. They're sort of all kinds of odd, you know, nuts. Everything's dried husks. There's even a feather in here. Look for something that really does look natural. I mean, I like the neutral tones in this. I think are perfect for this arrangement. And you can just take them and sort of set them along the plate if you like. One other thing I forgot to mention that I actually put in here. It's kind of obscured at this point, but you can either use it in the arrangement itself, inside, or you can put it around the outside edge, and that would be Spanish moss. It's a nice filler. It kind of gives things a rustic look. It's almost like hair. You just kind of have to tease it out a little bit, but you can always use this and kind of put it around the outside edge to obscure the plate if you really don't want, you know, if you don't want to see the plate. I'll turn it so you can see a little more. It would sort of be like this. It would just cover up the base of the arrangement this way. So if you want to use that, you can. But, you know, personally, I like this one is so full and colorful that I think putting too much more around it is going to take away and just look a little too busy. So I would stick more for this one with, you know, there's even, you know, whole things like this that are just, you know, right in nice neutral, the colors that won't take away from the arrangement itself. So, and again, I'm partial to bittersweet. I found I have another little branch of it that's, you know, essentially surrounding it, looks very natural, and you know, the color and the shape of the vine is just beautiful. Well, that's this cornucopia, both floral and edible materials in here. Again, you can use whatever materials you like, just pick what looks nice to you. And, you know, if you've got any questions at all or any comments, you can go to my website. It's under construction. It's www.your-garden-variety.com. I hope to have a Facebook page up soon, too. Meanwhile, I'm going to be posting some photos from today's segment on Instagram as well as on my own Facebook page, so you can keep an eye out for those as well. And if you ever need any help with anything, I'm happy to show you how to do something, because being able to put something like this together, it doesn't really take skill. It just takes a little imagination and, you know, a little appreciation for what nature has to offer. So just enjoy. Happy Thanksgiving.